Hey, church family, we wanted to give you an update regarding what it looks like for our church to gradually return meeting again. And I know many of you are just as anxious as we are to get back together, but I know there are some of you who are still hesitant about being around people, and we understand both sides about this. What we want you to know is that what we're going to explain is subject to change. Okay, we've tried to make decisions based on what we know about the situation, what some of the other churches in our area are doing, but most of all, what is best for our church family. And we also know that many of you are still in the high-risk category, so if you're not comfortable gathering just yet, that's okay. We'll still be doing our online services, and we invite you to continue joining us and being a part of those. If you want to return, but you want to wear a mask, please feel free to do so. You need to do what you feel is necessary for your own health. And the thing about it is we have to use our own discretion in this. Now, when we do return meeting together, here's a couple things. We're not going to have our greeting time. We know many of you are looking forward to hugging the neck of those whom you love, but I would ask that you please refrain from any physical touch with other church members during the first few weeks that we begin gathering. You may feel like you can, but in doing so, what you may do is make someone unintentionally feel uncomfortable about returning and being a part of our gathering. So please refrain from doing so for the time being. We'll also forgo passing the offering plate. So please continue to drop off your tithes and offerings in the slot at the office door or in the drop boxes in the back of the sanctuary or the front of the sanctuary. So here's the plan, okay? We're going to return meeting in four phases. Our first phase introduces gathering together on Sunday mornings beginning May 24th. However, there's going to be some changes to the way that we gather. We have spent some time, as you can probably see behind me, reconfiguring the seating in our sanctuary so it accommodates better social distancing. There's plenty of room between each row that allows us to spread out as we need to. Everything has been cleaned and will be cleaned each week and in between services. But instead of coming back with just our normal two services, we're going to have three services. The service times are going to be at 8:30, 9:45, and 11 a.m. What we feel will work best for our church is if we divide by age. So anyone aged 65 and up will attend our earliest service at 8:30. We think this would be the best time for this age group since they would be the first group of people inside of our sanctuary. Anyone between the ages of 40 and 64 will attend our 9:45 service, and anyone aged 39 and below will attend our 11 o'clock service. Now, if there's an age difference between you and your spouse and you fall into two different service times, you can decide as a couple which service you guys are going to attend and come together. If you come and you bring your children, they will sit with you in the service. This is because during this first phase, we're not going to be having kids' church, we're not going to do nursery right away, and we think actually this is a unique opportunity for us to show our kids what it means for us to be able to gather together again. Of course, again, that's if you're comfortable in doing so. So anyone who's entering the church building for our 9:45 service and our 11 o'clock service, they will do so through the doors right behind me facing Blair Road. And when the service is over, everybody's going to exit either the side double doors or the doors in the back by the stage to go to your vehicles. And during the first phase, we're not going to have any activities outside of a Sunday morning service. As I mentioned, that means no kids' church, no youth, no adult Bible studies, no Sunday school classes, no nursery for the time being. The playground's also going to be closed. But any classes that have been gathering in an online format will continue to do so for this first phase. We will also not be having a physical Wednesday night gathering. That service is going to remain online and we'll continue to do what we've been doing. And for the first few Sundays, this is how we're going to operate. I know these changes are not what everyone desires, but please understand that we've made them with the best interests of our entire church body. And we intend to evaluate things in June to provide you another update regarding phase two. We love you, we're praying for you, and we're so excited to be able to start seeing you starting May 24th. We'll see you then.